All right, this is my list. This is my list of my favorite woolly mammoths. Starting with number one is Snuffleupagus from Sesame Street. He's my favorite woolly mammoth because he likes to talk and sometimes he has like cool stories to say. So, cause one time like on Sesame Street, he was talking to the yellow guy with lots of feathers, and he had this story about how like when he had to go to bed early and he couldn't because he had to watch TV. I guess it was like the they were watching The Real World, and there was like the season finale of The Real World. I think it was the third one, or whichever one was in Seattle, because I guess the Seattle one, there was a lot of rain. There was rain in there, or it was like sprinkling a lot, and I don't think it turned into rain all the way, because I think it was just like this is sprinkles are coming down. But like I think it was in the winter time, so it might have been snow. Sometimes it snows, because what happens with the water? Water comes down, and if it's cold enough, it turns into snow because it evaporates. And when it evaporates, the moisture from all the water droplets, it comes in and it starts to turn into ice, and it turns into like a white ice. And because of it's all cold and everything. But it has to be like cold, like cold enough to snow. Then that's when it could go, and it'll be like sometimes the snow comes down like little snowflakes, which is like a square or like a circle, but it has like lots of lines on it, because when it turns into frozen, it doesn't like freeze like regular, because it turns into like it pops little holes in it to make like a little design. And I guess like if you grabbed like a bunch of snowflakes and put it together, like 10 out of 20, or 9 out of 18, or like 7 out of 14, or like 11 out of 22, or to get 3 out of 6, they would all be the same, because I guess like half of all snowflakes are the same design, because I guess water looks all the same, and so when it all freezes at the same time, that's why a lot of the snowflakes all look all the same, but some are like warmer water droplets, because they come from not all the air is the same temperature, and so they go, and so when it falls down, like some of them are in like 0.1 degree temperature, and like others in like 0.2 degree temperature, and so they'll come down, but when they come down like at different times. And or like in different areas, like one's over there on like 24th Street, or the other one's like on Jefferson Street, and so there'd be different temperatures, and so they'd be coming down, and they come freezing down, and one like the on 24th Street, then on the Jefferson Street, they don't do the same thing, but the ones like on Baseline or over there on like on Berkeley Street, they'll probably be the same because they're closer together. But if we brought all the streets together like onto one street, then they're probably all the same if it's all the same temperature. But it has to be like if it was cold enough to for the snow, because if it wasn't cold enough still, then it wouldn't have snowflakes. So like if it was like 100 degrees like in temperature, then it wouldn't turn to snow because it's not cold enough. That's kind of hot. But they don't have like hot flakes. But I bet you if you're on the sun would be like really hot. I bet you when it comes down and be like little hot flakes. But I don't think anybody could figure it out, because no one's like ever been on the sun, because it's so hot. It's like 300 degrees or something like that, because it's so hot, because it's all made out of like charcoal and like lighter fluid and stuff like that. Because I guess when the airplane or the space shuttle was going around, they could smell it like charcoal and lighter fluid burning. That's why, and like they took a lot of tests, like they took a lot of the scents in space, and they put it and like did the scientist tests, and they started smelling what it smelled like, and it was like sort of like they could tell that it was like charcoal and then like lighter fluid.